From foxes to lions to even pandas, join me as I reveal to you some of the top cheaters in the animal kingdom, as well as those that mate for life. Number 13, wolves. Wolves are known for many things in the world, and not all of them are good things, especially when you consider that wolves are considered a bad omen and something that should be feared at all costs. Yet, despite their tags of being evil, they honestly are one of the most pure animals in the world when it comes to mating, as they truly do mate for life, barring the death of their mate, of course. In fact, they start mating with their partner as soon as 2 years old. In fact, that's how wolves are able to have such packs. They try to have a new litter of wolf cubs every single year, thus growing their numbers and ensuring that the pack survives. Oh, and if you recall how many animal physiologies work, the older you get, the more unlikely it is that you have children. This doesn't happen for wolves. It's just the opposite, in fact. A female wolf can have cubs until she dies, further ensuring the lifespan of the pack. So, as you can see, wolves most definitely can be fierce and aggressive, but when it comes to love, they stick by their partners for life, no matter what. 12. The Queen Bee. A lot has been said about beehives over the years, including their very unique structure when it comes to who does what. And if you know anything about beehives, you know that the very bee that is at the top of the ladder is the queen bee. She is the one that they protect with their lives. She is the one who makes all the bees that live in the hive, and by that extension, she's a bee that mates with a lot of bees within the hive. How many? Well, during one of her mating runs, it's said that she'll go and mate with about 40 different drone bees. Oh, but that's not the weirdest part of this cheating scheme, because it's the males who happily go and swarm her in order to get her pregnant. And then, once they do the deed, they die. Yeah, the males give their lives in order for the queen to have their genetic material so that she can lay eggs. Kind of seems like a one-sided relationship, don't you think? But it's important to remember that once this happens, she has the ability to lay a ton of eggs, ensuring the longevity of the hive. It's even said that with her mating with more and more drones allows her to have a longer reign as a queen, as the other bees find her more attractive. Number 11. Gibbons. You might not be fully aware of the gibbon species, but to put it basically, they're very furry monkeys. Yet they're very furry monkeys that act like a sitcom couple when things are going right in the relationship. In fact, you could argue that they're very human-like in regards to how a good marriage works for them. For example, once they go and find their mate, they create a very deep bond, one that many times carries them throughout their lives, which can be just as long as some humans, as they can live up to 40 years. Not only that, but once they go and have a family, they take equal partnership in raising them, which is very unlike many animals where it's one parent who does most of the raising. Again, very human. And just like an old married couple, when they're not raising the kids, they're spending time with one another. Whether it's through simple acts of grooming or talking or just being with one another, they have a very strong bond. Granted, not all of these relationships end the right way, which is also very human in nature, but they are one of the rare animal species that sometimes do stay faithful to their partners, and that's worth praising. 10. Bonobos. Now, if you want to see an example of a monkey species that doesn't live in the style of monogamy and prefers to just get with whoever is available, that would be the bonobos. These are primates that not only endorse polygamy, they will do it as a way of connecting with their group at large. Confused? Well, in certain groups of animals, there is tension as to what one might do to get power or change the paradigm of the collective. To try and show favor with the others, they'll have a party of sorts where they all get with one another and literally share multiple partners, thus building up friendships and alliances and possibly growing their family as a whole. Weird? Oh yeah, but it apparently works for them in a big way. Just as interesting though, the males and females won't just mate with the opposite gender. They'll sometimes mate with the same gender should the desire arise. Number 9. Beavers. It's almost poetic that beavers are one of the few species that endorse monogamy. After all, you have to leave it to beaver, right? Get it? the sitcom. I'll move on. Anyway, yes, beavers are monogamous, and they go to some extremes to ensure that their relationships last a long time. No, I don't mean that they go and fight off other beavers who try and get in on what they got, but rather, it's stated that once the work for the day is done, the male and female beavers will interact with one another for great lengths of time, thus ensuring that their connection is strong and cannot be easily broken. Very touching. Once young beavers are born, co-parenting begins, further strengthening their bonds and giving their children something to aspire to. How very human-like. Like other animals on this list, there are some cases of beavers fooling around with others, but because of how they build up the relationships with their mates, it doesn't shatter the marriage. I bet I know some humans who wish this was the case with them. 8. Topi antelopes. Okay, this one isn't so much cheating, but an act to try and ensure the survival of the species. Roll with me on this, okay? This is the tale of the topi antelopes, a species that is very much unlike anything you've seen on this list so far, and for a very simple reason. The female topi antelopes are only fertile for one day every year. Yeah, that's a thing, and it creates some very aggressive females as a result. When their time of the year comes, they won't just go and mate with a male, they'll mate with that male multiple times and then go find another male and go mate with them. Sometimes multiple partners and sessions within a single day, all to make sure that they get pregnant and are able to have kids. In fact, this distinction is so different in the topi antelope that the males are actually the ones who will refuse a mating session with a female because they're not into it, which is again the exact opposite of most animal species, especially humans. I'm just saying. Sometimes the females will be so aggressive that they will interrupt other mating sessions in order to mate with the males, which sometimes cause the males to attack the females to get them away from them. A very strange example of when nature calls, don't you think? Number 7. Shingleback skinks. No, this is not a made-up word. It's a very real species of reptile that live in Australia, and they too are a species that prefers to be with one mate for the rest of their lives. And not unlike humans, they'll go through the motions of courtship in order to earn the love and respect of their prospective mate. Now, no, the skink, still a real thing, won't buy the mate flowers or give them candy, but they will caress them lovingly and even licking them to show affection. Cute, but also gross in some ways. Also, not unlike humans, courting sometimes takes up to months at a time to ensure that they make the right connection, which shows that these creatures have a great amount of patience. Then, once they do get together, their connection is so strong that the marriage will last decades, barring a partner dying. 6. Hedge sparrow and barn swallow. I'm putting these two bird species together because they honestly do act similarly when it comes to how they mate and how they cheat on their mates. To their credit, once they get with someone, they don't just ignore them and treat them like meat, though you could in that way. Rather, they will go with one male bird and then look for another male bird to mate with. Ravenous? Not satisfied? Not quite. Rather, they're not ones to gamble. They'll go and be with multiple partners because they want to make sure that they can lay the most eggs possible and thus have more children. They'll go and seek out what they feel are the best males for the job and then be with them and look for the next best male for the job. In regards to the barn swallow, they'll not just look for the best male, they have visual cues that alert them to the males not being the right kind for them, including not having the best sheen to their feathers. Number 5. Barn owls. On the more positive side of bird relationships, you have the barn owl, which honestly shouldn't be too much of a surprise, as owls are very smart and wise. Right, Legend of Zelda fans? Anyway, barn owls truly do believe in having one partner for all of time, and they'll go far to try and woo said mate into being with them. One way they'll do it is via making mating calls and hoping they'll respond. They'll also offer them gifts of dead mice as a token of affection. Gross, but kind of sweet. The females have a telltale signal of a sound that'll alert males to whether they're interested in them or not. And once they're mated, they're bonded for a life. Again, very wise animals, these owls. 4. Jumping spiders. Okay, so this one is a very interesting case of cheating, and it has one heck of a twist at the end. It all has to do with how the jumping spider finds its many mates. Because instead of giving the woman it desires gifts or trying to court them in the long term, they instead will go onto a stage and literally dance the night away to try and attract them to mate with him. It's a very complex kind of dance as well, one that makes not only use of visual movements but also makes sounds via vibrations. So it's a literal song and dance number. Who knew spiders knew how to cut up a rug? All the females in the area will watch the male spider as he does his dance, and then he'll choose his spider to be with, and if he does one final right move, they'll be together, until he moves on to the next spider. What's the twist? Well, in this culture, not unlike ancient Rome in some ways, if you botch the final move at the end, you have to pay the price. Mainly, if you screw up mating with a female, she'll eat you. Enjoy! Number 3. Octopods. While we've seen many creatures of the land and sky show off their cheating and monogamous ways, what about the creatures of the sea? Well, for the octopods, also known as octopus, they believe in the ways of monogamy. But once again, there's a bit of a twist in this tale. Because unlike many relationships on this list, octopods don't live that long. In fact, they live only about 2 years, meaning that they get to be with their loved ones only a very short time before they die. In fact, they are said to only be able to mate once in their lifetime before they die. Not exactly a long-lasting relationship, but that's not exactly their fault now, is it? There are some exceptions to this rule, as some octopods are able to mate with one another many times before succumbing to death, but it is a rarity. Still, at least they get to find their soulmates. 2. North American elk. For those who don't know what a harem is, it basically means that one man gets to mate with a whole bunch of females that are under his purview. Some of these men even have dozens of wives. But surely this is only a thing that happens with humans, right? Wrong. For the North American elk, they have a very odd yet simple tradition that determines who mates with who. Basically, they'll compete for the right to be with the ladies, oftentimes through posing and posturing and displaying their prominent features, and sometimes via actually fighting. If the females accept a male, they'll be allowed to mate with up to 60 females during the 2-month mating period. So if only one male is chosen, that literally means there's an elk harem in the wild. Number 1. Bald Eagle. Yes, the very symbol of freedom is also a symbol of monogamy. Truly, this is a message from the heavens that the bald eagle is a very special kind of bird. Anyway, the bald eagles are actually very special when it comes to their monogamy, as they do something that humans fail to do often, making long-distance relationships work. You see, by the time they're 5, they'll have found their mates, but then they'll fly away from each other to go and do various other things, including hunting and flying to new lands. But when mating season arrives, they meet up once again as if they never left. Their relationships are said to last over 20 years at times. Thanks for watching, everyone! What did you think of these animals who cheat or have monogamous relationships? Which animal species is the most surprising to you as to their placement on the list? Which were you not surprised at in terms of their mating rituals? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.